Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Vital Induction. In this video, I am going to show you how to use ultrasound to successfully perform superficial cervical plexus block. Secondly, I am going to tell you which are the conditions in which this block is extremely useful. Thirdly, I am going to narrate in which conditions you should preferably avoid this block. So friends, let's get started. Superficial cervical plexus block is a block which is performed on C2 to C4 nerves. You may ask me, the superficial cervical plexus block can be performed by landmark technique. Then what is the use of ultrasound? With ultrasound, we can avoid inadvertent injection into the arteries. We can avoid intravascular injection. We can avoid deep blockage, blockage of recurrent laryngeal nerve, blockage of phrenic nerve, deep cervical plexus block, brachial plexus block. So these are the advantages which make ultrasound superior over landmark technique. Superficial cervical plexus is formed by ventral rami of C2, C3 and C4 nerves. The roots of C2, C3, C4 nerves combine to form four terminal branches. These are number 1, lesser occipital nerve, number 2, greater auricular nerve, number 3, transverse cervical nerve, and number 4, supraclavicular nerve. Now the area from which these terminal branches carry sensation are the area around the auricle, the anterolateral part of the neck, the clavicle, and the acromioclavicular joint. It can be used to provide post-operative analgesia for any surgery done over the anterolateral part of the neck. It can also be used to perform minor procedures like drainage of abscess, removal of lymph nodes, insertion of internal jugular catheters, and suturing of small lacerations. The ultrasound probe used in this case is high frequency linear probe. The position of the patient can be semi-sitting position or backup position with head turned towards the opposite side. The area over the neck can be prepared with chlorhexidine or iodine based solution. The probe is placed as such it lies over the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid at its midpoint. 1.5 inch of 25 to 27 gauge needle can be used for this procedure. The probe is placed over the midpoint of sternocleidomastoid muscle on its posterior border. The needle is inserted in an in-plane technique under the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Needle should not move more than 2 cm and an injection of 5 to 10 ml of local anesthetic should be injected after regular aspiration. Care should be taken not to puncture the prevertebral fossa. The injection should be performed under the sternocleidomastoid muscle after visualizing this superficial cervical plexus, as shown in this ultrasound video. So coming to the last part, which are the conditions in which you should avoid this block? Number 1, patient refusal. Number 2, there is infection over the site of injection. Number 3, the patient is allergic to local anesthetic. Number 4, the patient is having contralateral phrenic nerve paralysis. Number 5, the patient has a history of the neck surgery. And lastly, the patient has a history of neck radiation. So friends, this is all about usage of ultrasound to perform superficial cervical plexus block. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any doubt or you want to share your experiences and knowledge, I will be extremely happy if you share those under the comment section. I will meet you in my next video. Till then, bye.